Hi guys, today I am doing the Zodiac Sign Book Tag. This tag was created by Hardback Hoarder and I saw it on Vanessa's channel, so I'm gonna leave both links down below and I just thought it was really, really fun. I think overall zodiac signs are a really interesting and fun thing. I do feel like often you can see that different character traits do fit the people that have the zodiac sign. But yeah, let's just get into the questions. So first is Aries. Would probably take on a dragon with their bare hands. For this one, I'm going with Katza from the Grayskull Realm trilogy. She is a badass. She has a special ability, so it is definitely sometimes a bit easier for her, but overall she is just such a badass mentally. Like, her ability gives her strength, but she, you know, still is like so strong in her head and does all of these things that just blow me away. Then we have Taurus. Looks innocent but would rip you to shreds. For this one I have Lila Bard from the Shades of Magic trilogy. I mean, Lila, you know, is one of my favorite characters and just one of my favorite badasses. And I do feel like she is just someone that looks maybe like really tiny and like a little girl and just like ha ha ha, but then she just fucking rips your heart out, so. Next is Gemini, the sassiest sass master, and for this one I'm choosing Kenji from the Shadowmere trilogy. It has been a while since I've read the trilogy, but I remember him being funny and extremely sassy, and he didn't care about anybody being offended, he just wanted to be sassy. Next we have Cancer, made you feel all the feels. For this one I am choosing Severus Snape from the Harry Potter trilogy. You know that I personally am a huge Snape lover, acknowledging that he was an asshole and he was kind of a dick, but still he gave me lots of feels and still I love him. I can't help myself. Next is Leo, badass that is actually a cinnamon roll in disguise. This really wasn't easy, but in the end I feel like I have the perfect choice, and that for me is Finnick from The Hunger Games. I mean, when we first meet him, he is just kind of the flirty guy and he acts like he is just really like arrogant and nothing can ever irritate him, but do we learn that is not who he is. He is a cinnamon roll and I just want to hug him. Then we have Virgo, independent boss ass bitch. And for this one I have to go with Karu from the Daughter of Smoke and Bone trilogy. Karu is definitely an independent boss ass bitch. She loves her friends and she really likes to be in company, but when there's something she has to do, something important or something to save the world, then she just, you know, takes off alone and does what she needs to do, and she is pretty badass and pretty independent boss ass bitch. Then we have Libra, ray of sunshine that makes you feel warm and fuzzy. For this one I could not decide between Jane Bennett from Pride and Prejudice and Peter Brett from The Hunger Games. I wrote it on Twitter the other day, I feel like they are the same character, you know, like Peter is a gender bent version of Jane. Then we have Scorpio. Yes, I understand your point, but I'm still right. And that is definitely Susanna from the Daughter of Smoke and Bone trilogy. She could also be the sassiest sass master, just as Kenji would also say, I understand your point, but I'm still right. I love Susanna for her kind of sassiness and her kind of constantly being like, okay Karu, that's true, but still. Susanna is a great character and really kind of balances out Karu's kind of personality. I don't know, they fit together perfectly. Sagittarius yells "Ay!" every time a fight breaks out. For this one I kind of had to choose Tyrion from TV show Game of Thrones because I haven't read the books, but I still always include him in my bookish things because that's just how I roll. Tyrion is basically constantly drunk, and so I feel like he would be someone, as long as he's not in it, that would yell "Ay!" every time a fight breaks out. Then we have Capricorn, hides in the shadows but deserves to see the spotlight. And by the way, I am actually a Capricorn. For this one I'm choosing a character that, while I have read the books, I'm kind of talking about the TV show character, and that is Murta? From the Outlander show. I don't remember much from him in the books because it has been a while and he just never stood out to me that much. Like, I remember liking him, but in the TV show it is just present how much of an amazing character he is and how important he is, and that just really, I don't know, I feel like he deserves a lot more love from everyone, like from people in the story, from people outside the story, like from readers and watchers and fans. I love him so much. I really started appreciating him so much. Then we have Aquarius, the quiet but psycho one. This one I found so hard. The only one I could come up with was Eli from Vicious, which obviously is very psycho, but he is able to hide that pretty well. And finally, we have Pisces, needs protecting at all costs. And for this one, I'm choosing my ultimate bae, Haymitch. Baymitch. Haha, that's not what I came up with. I think Vanessa was the one that came up with it once in the comments, but still, Baymitch. You know how I love Haymitch and that he is my little baby and I want to protect him from all the evil in the world because he already went through so much and almost lost so much more and I want to protect him from all of these things. I don't want anything to ever happen to him again and I want to take care of him. I would even give him a bath. I don't even care. Haymitch is my bae. So this was the Zodiac sign book tag, which was a lot of fun. And I'm just gonna tag everyone that is also a Capricorn. If you do the tag, let me know in the comments. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I guess I'll see you soon. Bye. Why does it keep happening to me? Could you just not for just a second?